Hey everyone, how's it going? This is Ash and a warm welcome to my latest Let's Play of Train Simulator 2022. And today folks, we're going to be using a Robinson 04 steam engine. And the route today folks is the Netherfield Nottingham route. And we're going to be going to Hucknall, number 2 colliery, with a freight train, as you know. It ain't too often I do steam, as to be honest with you, there is a reason for that. I'm not very good at driving steam engines in this train simulator. I'm actually very bad at it, so that's my reasons why I don't cover steam engines very often. But I've had some emails from some of you asking me to cover steam engines, as not many people cover steam engines in Let's Plays. So, as you know, I do take your suggestions and ideas on board. And here we go. This is the second attempt, as the first one had no narration. And I'm getting used to the controls, so I thought I'd give this one a go. And I'll just do a little bit of narration here and there, as I will need to concentrate more, as it's a lot different to the normal diesels and electrics that I usually cover on my Let's Plays. And without further ado, let's unpause the game and let's get started. Just as a side note, folks, I am driving with extreme caution as we are in wet weather, and I'm not sure how this will affect the braking distance and stuff. And I definitely do not want to get booted from the scenario, especially after putting all this effort in. But anyways, I'm just going to get ready to start. So, just checking the signal ahead. Although we can continue to keep going, folks, as we do have the ground signal, and I've just tabbed, so there is no permission denied, so that's grand. And we'll continue to keep going at a caution speed until we are clear of the freight yard. So, fingers crossed, hope this one works out as well. Well, I've not really covered this route much, to be honest. Although it is a very nice one, but I have the modern day Midland mainline as well, so I did cover that one quite a bit in January, and I will be revisiting that one at some point in the future as well. So there will be some more new videos to come of that too. Thank you. be honest with you, folks, I'm not the best at covering steam engines, and as you know, I'm not familiar with the controls and stuff, so I'm trying my best to get the maximum pressure to get this train up the hill, and we are going uphill as well, so that adds to the challenge. But if I'm following any passenger trains that are NPC trains, then they should be well ahead of me by the time I catch up with them, so hopefully there won't be any red signals to contend with. Although I don't mind a challenge, and I definitely do like to cover steam and stuff every now and again, but I think this will be the last one for this bank of Let's Plays, as I like to cover various ones. But rest assured, I will be coming back to the steam trains and stuff, and I may put one more into this lot of videos anyways. But for those of you that like steam trains and stuff, I just thought I'd do this one for you as well. Okay then, now we are up the hill, we should be able to gain a bit of speed now as we start to level off, and we will be going downhill slightly as well, so that should be able to give us some advantage of making up for lost time. And we're just about to pass through Daybrook down. I think it's just a single platform, I have no idea. And we are driving in twilight, which is nice. As you know, I do like to cover different types of scenarios, be it passenger, freight, and I do plan to include more steam in my Let's Plays as well. But they won't be regular. I'll just do them as the odd extra video here and there. At least until I get better at driving them anyways. I'm just going to blow the whistle just to warn anyone to keep back as we pass through the station with a heavy load. And we do have an upcoming speed limit of 25 miles an hour, so I will need to prepare for that as well. So I'm going to ease off the car here. And I may just coast, use the gravity as a friend. Thank you. That was a lucky signal there. Thankfully, the dispatcher gave me the okay to pass it at danger. Otherwise, I probably would have got booted from the scenario back then. And to be honest, I will not redo this one. I will just say thanks for watching. And I would have just called it quits there, but so far so good. We do have a green signal, so that's all grand. As to be honest with you, I definitely will try to avoid getting burnt from the scenarios if I can stop in time and stuff, but no bother. We're just coming off this track now, and we are in a 25 miles an hour speed zone, and this will increase to 50 miles an hour, but it'll be very unlikely that I'll be able to get this train up to that speed, as to be honest, it does seem to be buggy, unless I'm doing something wrong. But either way, I'm going to close the regulator a bit, just see if we can get a bit more speed out of it. So it does go in increments of about 10, well, 5 and 10, well, that can be random. This is definitely different to the other trains that I've covered. All in all, so far so good. We're just coming up to Bulwell Forest down platform, so we'll be passing through there. Fingers crossed, no red signals, but if I cannot stop in time and I get booted from the scenario, then so be it. Then I'll just call it quits. But hopefully, fingers crossed, metaphorically speaking, that won't be the case. Okay folks, I'm not sure what's happening here, but this train seems to be very buggy. It's really struggling to bring this freight up the hill. and I'm losing too much steam pressure. I don't know if it's a bug with the add-on, or if I'm doing something wrong, or both. We are now back up to 15 miles an hour, and I'm currently using just under 70% of regulator, so I'm not sure if that helps or not, but I'm just checking the signals with the tab key just in case I have to take action to get ready to slow down. But thankfully I don't think that's going to be necessary, as the distance signal is off, so that's grand. Folks, I'm not sure what the top speed of this Robinson 04 is capable of, as I know next to nothing about the real things, but I think we might be able to get to about 30 miles an hour, so I'm just gonna knock the regulator down just one more step to see how fast we can get this train to go. folks, I have a sneaky suspicion that this train is buggy, and to be honest with you, I really can't get the speed out of it, so it seems very weak on inclines from what I can tell you. But we're not too far away now from Hucknall, so one more signal to go and we will be in the terminal, and then we will have to reverse this freight train into a siding, I'm assuming, just like we did in the last Let's Play. So all should be grand. I'll just have to remember to use Control and Tab just to get permission to pass any signals. So I'm going to ease off the power here, and I'm just going to idle the reverser and get ready to start slowing down, and just to make sure that the rear of the train is clear of the junction as well. So all should be grand. So we'll switch to the reverse, and then it'll be time to start doing our reverse maneuver. So just need to make sure that we are not going to obstruct the switch, or the points as it's called. So what I'm going to do, I'm just going to view it from this side, you know, it'll be easier. So just going to wait for that to take effect. Looks like I've slowed down too soon, so it's nothing really I can do. But anyways, I'll try and correct it if I can, but if not, I'll just quit it here, and then we'll just see what happens. Okay folks, we do have a shunt signal, so I think we should be grand to go, but just as a precaution, I will do a tab and, well, a control and tab, just to make sure that the signaler is happy with this, okay? Okay, so it is showing up on the HUD, so we should be okay on this one. And we can just then follow the instructions in terms of uncoupling the train and stuff. And then that should be us done for this let's play. That, my friends, is the end of this scenario and, of course, this let's play. Thankfully, we was able to complete it. Although, to me, this steam engine does seem to be a wee bit underpowered. Although we do have a fairly heavy train, but it does feel quite lightweight, in my opinion, as it seems to struggle going up the hills and that. But this one is the Robinson 04 steam engine, and the route is the Nottingham Netherfield route. So that's just the details for those of you that are interested in the add-on yourselves. Anyway, folks, that's the end for now. I'll catch you in the next one.